Being an artist is not easy. You can just make something and immediately turn it into a masterpiece. I tell you, it takes courage, patience, and a lot of time to complete one piece. Or it could probably mess up your sleeping schedule. But believe me, you will appreciate the process you have gone through. You will appreciate the artwork of what you've made. Hey friends, this is Angela Catampos and welcome to another video. And today, I will be teaching you the basics of pen tool. And in the end, we will be creating a minimalistic background. I know a lot of you may think that you need advanced tools to compose an artwork, but in this case, you just need your mouse. But if you have a pen tablet, I highly recommend it, for it'll be much easier to navigate. Before getting into all that complicated stuff, let us first know about the pen tool. Basically, it is one of the powerful and most useful tool in Adobe Illustrator. You can absolutely create anything and everything, from logos to minimalistic vector background. To begin, let's do three levels of practice exercise. I have inserted a Google Drive link down in the description below where you can find the practice sheet and the PDF summary of this video. First, you need to locate it in the toolbar. Select it and it will automatically set the stroke weight to 1 point. Second, create a straight line. You will see that there is a path that is connected to the cursor. The line is somewhat the path you are trying to make. Click anywhere in the canvas to create multiple anchor points. Third, to close the path, put the cursor to the original location of the anchor point. But if you only want to cut the path, just press escape on your keyboard. Fourth, if you want to create a curved path, click once on the canvas and put the other anchor point to your desired location, then drag to create a curved path. The more you drag, the more it will become arced. Fifth, if you want to add an anchor point on an existing path, select any path you chose, click on it, and voila, you have a new point. You can drag it to form another path or a curve with the direct selection tool on the upper part of the toolbar. But if you change your mind and want to remove it instead, just click the point again and it'll automatically be removed. Note that you can do this to any points. Next, level 2. This level is necessary for you to get used to creating paths and anchor points. Create multiple paths to form a triangle. Make a perfect square, click once and it'll create a guide. To get a perfect angle, hold shift and it'll angle to 45 or 90 degrees. After that, close the paths. Last shape, to create the star, just make multiple points and follow the guide. For the last level, we will be tracing this path. Again, create a curved path and drag it. As you can see, the line guide is also curved. To make that straight, click again the very last point. Then you can continue with making multiple curved paths. To color this, go to the lower part of the toolbar and select the color field to activate it, and click the black color.
Now that we've finished three levels, let's get started and create a minimalistic background.
To get things actually started, of course you should create a new canvas. Next, you need a reference. Choose a scenery photo that you like to recreate and import it to Adobe Illustrator. You could also place a color palette. Drag and put it beside your canvas. But if you want to create your own, feel free to do so. Alright, let's start by making a grass plane on the lower part of the canvas. Then select the pen tool and click on the corner side of the canvas to start your anchor point. Just create some squiggly lines and curves until you can form a grass plane. With the eyedropper tool, I chose a darker shade of blue from the color palette. Next, I added some extra grass just for details. Create a somewhat sharp-looking triangles on both sides of the grass plane. Let's do small mountains on the upper part. Just do what you did on the grass plane but make it curvier as if making mountains. Now for the trees. It is the same process with the grass.
Do multiple tall and small ones until you reach the corner of the canvas. If the object overlays another, press Ctrl plus open square bracket if you want the object to go backward, and Ctrl plus close square bracket to go forward. For my case, I want my trees to go backward. Again, let's make another mountains and choose a lighter shade of color. Click and drag to make curves until you reach the corner and put it behind the trees. Make another layer of mountain. Try to make an arc in the middle to make it look like it is steeper from the rest. Now that we're almost finished, let's add our sun. To make that, just create a semicircle path and put it behind the mountains to make it look like it is setting. To create the sky, cover the top part of the canvas and click the gradient fill on the lower part of the toolbar. Let's apply a sky blue color that fades down to white. And there we go, we have our sky. For the clouds, make random curve and squiggly lines and connect it to the original point to close the path. And lastly, for the reflection of the lake, to make your life a bit easier, highlight everything on the top part and duplicate it by pressing Alt and dragging it down. Now, right-click on the canvas and go to Transform and then Reflect. Make sure it is set horizontally. Then drag all the objects in the bottom part and put it backwards behind everything. Stretch it a bit down and set the opacity to 50%. And there we have it! We have our minimalistic background.
There are tons of things you can do with just a pen tool, from minimalistic to complex designs and artworks. Everything can be done with just that. You just need the patience to learn and a wide imagination. So, start with a small step and let your creativity overflow through you. Thank you and have a great day!